Welcome learners, EdSAM platform, MHRD, Government of India. I am Dr. Mujibul Hasan Siddiqui, Associate Professor, Department of Education, Aligarh Muslim University, Aligarh. The topic is concept of ICT and its use in education. After presentation of this module number 1, we will be able to know concept of ICT, understand different aspect of ICT, make the application of ICT in teaching learning process, realize the various values of ICT, develop interest in daily activities of ICT, develop skills in the area of ICT, enhance our attitude toward ICT. ICT stands for 3 words: information, communication and technology. Information, knowledge communicated or gained through study, instruction, research concerning a particular facts or circumstances, etc., factual data, news. Then come to the communication, transmitting, interchange of thoughts, opinions or information by speech, writing or signs. Then come to technology. Technology is the selection of various techniques, skills, methods, models, processes and tools utilized in process of gaining information and communicating to the others. The easiest form of technology is the development and use of essential means, sources or fundamental tools. In historical development of ICT, including the printing press, the telephones and the internet, have minimized physical obstacles to communicate and permitted people to interact freely on a global platform. Concept of information and communication technology, ICT, can be defined as a diverse set of technological tools and resources used to communicate and to create, disseminate, store and manage information. These technologies include computers, the internet, broadcasting technologies, radio and television and telephony. ICT stands for information and communication technology. Access through the telecommunication, it is akin to information technology but provides attention mostly on communication technologies. This consists of the internet, wireless networks, cell phone and other communication mediums. ICT is wide term, just like an umbrella that consists of any communication objects or devices or application, including television, radio, printer, cellular phone, computer and network, hardware and software, website, pen drives, cassettes, satellite systems, projectors and video conferencing and teleconferencing useful for distance learning. Since long time, information and communication technologies have given people of our society wonderful modern communication capabilities. For instance, human beings can communicate in right time with other people in different countries all over the world, utilizing technologies such as internet, messaging, voices over IP and video conferencing. In our social network, many websites like LinkedIn, Facebook, academic education, Goodreads, etc., and other users from all over the world to continue to contact and make excellent communication every day. The concept of global village is the result of the development of modern information and communication technologies in recent years in our human society. For this significant reason, we used to see ICT in the context of the effect of modern technologies on our society. Tools of ICT. Information and communication technology tools are digital infrastructure such as computers, laptops, desktop, data projectors, software programs, printers, scanners and interactive teaching box. ICT tools are instruments or devices or any object, applied information and communication technology, for example, computer, video, conferencing, cellular phone, towers, all kinds of software, television, radio, laptop, etc. ICT tools are highly effective tools for approaching knowledge widely among the people through the internet services, and any person can easily approach these services through the services of internet. There are several ICT tools which are radio. Radio is the oldest ICT tools, which plays significant role for entertaining a large number of people in past and in present, particularly in rural areas. Radio makes the favorable attitude of interest toward recent information applicable to them in our vast developing society. Print media. Print media is one of the most important ICT tools. Print media includes books, encyclopedia, newspapers, newsletters, magazines, posters, banners, bill cards, brochures, flyers. Print media can be used at any time and anyone can keep in record. Then television. Television is an effective audiovisual ICT tool. Audience with the low literacy skills can watch television. It is more helpful than other means of communication. Doordarshan and other television channels cover the entire population of our global society. Chart and folders. Charts and folders are very helpful to include any kind of information and communication to the learners with the help of dynamic experts in a particular area. Then come to the slide presentation. Slide means to move smoothly along a surface. A slide is a modern presentation of ICT tool. There is no need to download anything. These are transparent pictures. Slides are most useful to make an inspiring presentation of different types of information. With the application of projectors, a large reflection of a slide is reflected on a big screen. We can make a large number of slides of information. Then come to computer. A computer is a programmable electronic device designed to accept data, perform prescribed mathematical and logical operations at high speed, and display the result of these operations. Desktop and laptop computers, tablets and smartphones are some of the different types of computers. A computer is an electronic machine that can solve different problems, process data and store, retrieve data and perform calculations faster and efficiently than human. A computer is a machine or device that perform processes, calculations, operations based on instructions provided by a software or hardware program. It is designed to execute applications and provides a variety of solutions by combining integrated hardware and software components. A computer is made up of multiple parts and components that facilitate user functioning. A computer has two primary categories, hardware and software. Hardware, physical software that houses a computer, processes, memory, storage, communications, ports, peripheral devices. Software includes operating system and software applications. A computer works with software programs that are sent to the underlying hardware architecture for reading, interpretation and execution. Computers are classified according to computing power, capacity, size, mobility and other factor as personal computers, desktop computers, laptop computers, mini computers, handheld computers and devices main frames of supercomputers. Then basic parts of computer, there are different parts of computers. Computer case, monitor, keyboard, mouse and power cord. Each part plays a significant role whenever we utilize computer. Now come to the computer case. The computer case is made up of metal and plastic case, or we can say box, that keeps the important components of the computer, including the motherboard, central processing unit and power supply. The front of the computer case often has an on and off button and one or more optical devices. Motherboard, the main circuit board of computer, is a motherboard. This is a thin plate which keeps the central processing unit, memory, connectors for the hard drive and optical devices, expansion cards to control the video and audio, and connections to ports of our computers, such as USB ports. The motherboard connects directly or indirectly to each and every part of computer. Central processing unit. The central processing unit is used to call a processor. This is installed inside the computer case on the motherboard. The CPU is also as the brain of the computer. The function of CPU is to bring out commands. Whenever we press a key, click the mouse or start an application, we use to send instructions to the CPU. The speed of a processor is measured in megahertz or millions of instructions per second, and gigahertz or billions of instructions per second. A faster processor can finish our instructions more quickly. RAM, random access memory. RAM is short-term memory of our computer. If we make calculation on computer, the data is temporarily stored in RAM until it is required. RAM is measured in megabytes or gigabytes. The more RAM we have, the more things our computers can do at the same time. If we don't have sufficient RAM, we can notice easily that our computer is slow, which we open a large number of programs. Due to this reason, most of the people have different RAM to their computers to make the faster performance in the functioning. Then come to the monitor. The monitor functions with a video card situated inside the computer case to show images and text on the screen. Keyboard. The keyboard is most important part of computer. The main role of keyboard is to communicate with a computer. Then mouse. The mouse is another very useful tool for communicating with computer. It is commonly known as a pointing device. It helps us to point to objects on the screen. With the help of mouse, we click on them and move them from one place to another place. A mouse has two types, as optical mouse and mechanical mouse. The optical mouse has an electronic eye for detecting movement. This mouse is easier to clean. The mechanical mouse helpful to rolling ball for detecting movement, but it needs regular cleaning and functioning nicely. Now come to the touchpad. A touchpad, also termed as a trackpad, is a touch sensitive pad that enables us to control the pointer by making a drawing motion with our fingers. Touchpads are commonly found on laptop computers. Now come to the laptop. A laptop is a personal computer that can be easily carried and used in a variety of situations. Laptops are designed for portability and have difference from desktop computers. A laptop is a computer which has an all-in-one design with a built-in monitor, keyboard, touchpad which reflects the mouse, and speakers. This means it is fully functional even when no peripheral are connected. Now come to the tablet computer. Similar to the laptops, tablet computers are designed for the portability. Tablet computers don't have keyboard or touchpads. Instead, the entire screen touch sensitive that permit us to type on a virtual keyboard and utilize our finger as a mouse pointer. Now come to the hard drive. The hard drive is ICT tool where we can make storage of our hardware, documents and other files. The hard drive is long-term storage. The data is still saved even if we turn off our computer or unplug it, such as pen drive, CD, DVD, etc. When we start a program or open a file, the computer copies some of the data from the hard drive onto the RAM. When we have to file, the data is copied back to the hard drive. The computer can start up and load program very fast, depend on fast hard drive. Power supply unit. The power supply unit is a computer change the power from the wall outlet to the type of power required by the computer. It supplies power through cables to the motherboard and other component. Now come to the expansion cards. Most computers have expansion slots on the motherboards that permit us to include different types of expansion cards. These are sometimes called PCI peripheral component interconnect cards. We never require including a PCI card because most motherboards have built-in video, sound, network and other capabilities. Printers. The most important function of printer is to make a print of document, photos and anything else that seen on the screen of our computer. There are several kinds of printers such as laser, inject and black and colored photo printer. Some of the other printers which have the facility to scan and copy document themselves. Speakers and headphones. Speakers and headphones are output tools of ICT. They also play a significant role in sending information from the computer to the person. They help us to hear sound and music clearly. We may connect them to the audio port of the USB port of computers. Some of the computers have built-in speakers in them. Microphones. A microphone is a kind of input device. These tools of ICT gains information from user. We can connect a microphone to record sound or talk with others distant persons over the internet. A large number of laptop computers equipped with built-in microphones. Web cameras. A web camera or webcam is also a type of input device of computer. These ICT tools can make a video recording and snapshots of pictures. Webcam can also send video over the internet in real time, which permit us for video chat or video conferencing with other distant person. Webcams also has a microphones for this purpose. Digital cameras. A digital camera permit us to shoot pictures and videos in a digital format. By connecting the cameras to USB port of our computer, we could be able to send the image from the cameras to the computer. Now come to the video card. The video card is accountable for what we see on the monitor. Most of the computers have a GPU graphic processing unit built into the motherboard in place of having a separate video card. If we like to play graphics intensive games, we can include a faster video card to one of the expansion slots to obtain better performance. Sound cards. The sound card is also termed as an audio card. The sound card is responsible for what we hear in the speakers or headphones. Most motherboards have integrated sound. We can make advancement to a dedicated sound card for higher quality sound. Network card or Wi-Fi. The network card permit our computer to communicate over a network and make the access of internet. It can either control with an internet cable or through a wireless connection, often called Wi-Fi. Most of the motherboard have built-in network connections, and a network card can also be added to an expansion slot. Bluetooth card or adapters. Bluetooth is a technology for wireless communication over short distances. It is generally used in computers to communicate the motherboards or added in a wireless network card. For example, a computer has no Bluetooth, we can purchase a USB adapter, generally called a dongle or mobile. A mobile device is a general term for any type of handheld computers. These devices are designed to be extremely portable and they can often fit in your hand. Some mobile devices like tablet, e-readers and smartphones are powerful enough to do many of the same things you can do with a desktop or laptop computers. E-readers. E-book include are also termed as the e-readers. They are similar to tablet computers. They are particularly designed for reading e-books, digital downloadable books. For instance, the Amazon Kindle, Barnes, Noble, Nook and Kobo. Most of the e-readers utilize an e-link display, which is very easy to read than a traditional computer display. We can even read in bright sunlight, just like a regular reading of book. A Kindle e-reader. We don't require a reader to read e-book. We can also read e-books on smartphones, tablets, laptops and desktop. Now come to the smartphone. A smartphone is a most competent version of a traditional cell phone. Other than the phone calls, voicemail, text messaging, a person can connect a smartphone to the internet over Wi-Fi or cellular network, which requires purchasing a monthly data plan. This means that we can use a smartphone for the same things as we would normally do on a computer, such as checking our email, browsing the web, or shopping online. A smartphone has a touch sensitive screen. A smartphone has no physical keyboard. We can type on a virtual keyboard and use our fingers to internet with the display. It has a high quality digital cameras and the capacity to play digital music and video files. Smartphones can replace ICT tools like an old laptop, digital music players and digital cameras in the same devices. Now come to the internet. The internet is the world level interconnected computer network that apply the internet protocol suite to link ICT tools worldwide. The internet begets a diversified information resources and services, such as the interlinked hypertext, documents and application of the worldwide www, electronic mail, telephony and file sharing. The internet is the large group of millions of computers around the world that are connected to one another. These computers are connected by phones, lines, fiber optic lines, coaxial cables, satellites and wireless connections. The internet is an effective tool of ICT to contribute to the development of education. Any person can have access to vast global information resources. Now come to the intranet. Intranet is a computer network that uses internet protocol technology to share information, operational system or computing services within an organization. Now come to the LAN. A local area network is a computer network that ascertains a comparatively small area. Generally, a LAN is restricted to a single room, building or group of building. One LAN can be connected to other LAN over any distance via telephone lines and radio waves. Now come to the WAN. A computer network in which the computers connected may be far apart, generally having a radius of more than 1 kilometer. Now come to the MAN. A metropolitan area network is a computer network that interconnect users with computer resources in a geographic area or region larger than that covered by even a large local area network, but smaller than the area covered by a wide area or network. Now come to the telephone. Telephone is also one of a strong way of communication. This is the simplest and easiest ways of communication. Now come to teleconferencing. Teleconferencing includes several interconnected telephones, PCs. Every individual can listen and interact to all of the others remains in the call. Since it includes a telephone network, therefore it is a teleconference call or something on audio conferencing call. Video conferencing. A video conferencing is a live visual connection between two or more people residing in separate locations for the purpose of communication. At the simplest, video conferencing provides transmission of static images and text between two locations. All the most sophisticated, it provides transmission of full motion video images and high quality audio between multiple locations. Digital library. A digital library is very helpful in the fields of education. The digital library provides information on various aspects and branches of education. Most of the cases in the area of teaching learning process, ICT is used in web-based learning, e-learning, flipped learning, blended learning, open and distance learning, in a smart classroom. Web-based learning. Web-based learning is a part of learning. It refers to a kind of learning which uses internet, mostly using a browser such as Chrome or Firefox, Internet Explorer. It can also be understood a types learning through the application of electronic devices, which plays significant role in learning, teaching and education. E-learning. E-learning is the application of electronic media, educational technology, information and communication technologies in education. E-learning is very suitable for the distance learning and flexible learning. It is also useful in collaboration with the face-to-face teaching in the conducive classroom environment. The effectiveness of each technology in e-learning varies and depends on the utilization. Now come to the self-directed learning. In self-directed learning, there is an effective integration of ICT in the school and classroom. This improves pedagogy and empowers students. Now come to the flipped learning. Flipped learning is as school work at home and homework at school. Now come to the four pillars of flipped learning. Number one, flexible environment, learning culture, then intentional content, and then professional educator. The flipped learning makes improvement in a collaborative and autonomous student learning. The application of ICTs in the teaching learning process increases the level of motivation among the students. Now come to the blended learning. Blended learning is often used to the practice of including both online and in-person hearing experiences at the time of teaching students in a blended learning courses. For example, a student might attend a class taught by a teacher in a traditional classroom setting while also independently completing online components of the course outside of the classroom situation. Blended learning is also termed as hybrid learning and mixed mode learning. It includes classroom based course video, recorded lectures, live videos and text charts and other digitally helped learning activities. Now come to the smart classroom. Smart classrooms are technology enhanced classroom that foster opportunities for teaching and learning by integrating teaching technology such as computers, specialized software, audience response technology, assisted listening devices network, and ऑडियो विजुअल कैपेबिलिटीज क्लासरूम सर्विसेज लीड्स दी सपोर्ट डिजाइन एंड प्लानिंग फॉर कैंपस लर्निंग स्पेसेस Dawson College in Montreal, Canada has 3 high-tech smart classrooms. These rooms are designed with group tables and interactive whiteboards around the perimeter of the room. 2 of the rooms have smart board technology, while the third and newest is an active learning lab with 8 Nureva walls that stretch around the room, providing 56 feet of digital workplace. It is the largest installation of Nureva visual collaboration solution in a single classroom. In these classrooms, students come together in a shared space to construct, manipulate, and negotiate meaning around a canvas. The environments become immersive. Learning happens on walls, desks, tables, and in conversations. The interactive surfaces become shared perceptual space where students discuss meaning, clarity, and come to a collective understanding which we in an environment with touch screen dedicated to creating opportunities for shared perceptual meaning. We can dig down and construct knowledge in a deeper way. We make rooms to not need personal devices, but the room personal devices to be applied in a complementary capacity. If we want students in exchanging, collaborating, and talking contemporary in class, then sharing public space should be the primary focus of work. Creation of a learner-centered environment. This is very important. National Research Council of the US provides definition of learner-centered environment as those that pay careful attention to the knowledge, skills, attitudes, and beliefs that learner brings with them to the classrooms. Learner-centeredness comes from constructivism's theory of learning. This theory considers learning as a process individuals construct meaning based on prior knowledge and experiences. New changes, new policies, new tools, new methods, and new technologies would help us to change the educational environment, commencing from the nursery education to higher education. There will be tremendous changes in the behavior of the learners with the use of effective information and communication technologies in classroom and outside the classroom situation. Now come to the recommendation. Some of the important recommendations regarding the ICT. ICT must be integral part of our life. We should shift from the teacher oriented classes to student oriented learning with the use of ICT tools. The use of ICT tools should be for augmenting learning based on feedback and remedial measures. The use of ICT must change the behavior of learners in right direction. The use of ICT influences researches in education. ICT must change face of education with the advancement in innovations in imparting and gaining analytical information. Now come to the other recommendation. ICT gives rich ambience and motivation for learners. ICT skills should not be limited to the MS Office, but include other programs and packages. There should be an integrated application to the ICT and learning. Then the teacher must improve. This is one of the most important recommendation. The teacher must improve and upgrade teaching learning process with the help of modern ICT tools. If the learners, gentle learners, want to ask any questions on this module number 1, you are requested to send questions on my email ID for your answer. My email ID is mhsiddiqui50@readymail.com mhsiddiqui50@gmail.com. Thanks.